Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi and today we are going to see the first function for Pandas library. We are just going to see that how we can just like save a particular file in this Google Colab notebook and how we can just perform some basic operations on that file, on the data using our Pandas library, right? So we are just gonna see these things today. Okay, so without wasting time, let's get started. But before that, let me just give you a quick revision at what we have done in the previous video. So in the previous video, I have told you that basically what is this Pandas library, what is this used for, and basically how you can just use that Pandas library in the online and offline mode. So on online, we just quickly need to write import pandas add pd. So basically we need not to install that, but in the offline one we need to just go to a particular terminal or command prompt or Windows PowerShell and we just need to write the command that is pip install pandas, and then the pandas library would be installed for us. Fine. So this was the idea about like this pandas library. Now let's quickly start the things for today and let me just zoom in for a while so that you can just have a better look. So I hope this much is fine. Yeah, this much is okay. So here we can just start writing the things for now. And firstly, what I will just let you know that how we can just store a particular file in this Google Colab notebook. So here you are seeing an option. As you just click on this, it is showing files. Just click on this option. Fine. So here it will say upload from device. Okay. So I would just like go here and I will just click this upload to session storage. Fine. I would just go here. Now here I would just get the options that basically from where you need to just like install your data. Fine. Store your data. So I have already made a like particular sample, and from that sample only that folder only I just taken a sample data set. I just prepared the sample data set. So just let me do one thing and I would just do as open. Fine. So this particular one is like being uploaded. I will just click on OK. So see, you here you can just see the data that is sample.csv. So this is the name for my like data which I have just taken, that is sample.csv. fine. So here you can just see that. So basically it is now like installed and stored in the session storage format this notebook. But one thing is here is that whenever you will like close this notebook and again reopen, then again you need to like store this data here. It will not be saved like here for particular for all time. No, it will not be that time. So whenever you just use your Google Colab, whenever you just open this notebook, you need to just save this here. Okay, and now I will just quickly close this. Fine. So let's get started with the code for today. And firstly, what I would just write, I would write my NumPy libraries. Fine. I would just import that by NumPy library, import NumPy as np. Now if you just want to know that what is this NumPy library, what is this basically used for, so you can just go and look at my playlist in which I have just made a playlist for the NumPy tutorials. You can just go and have a look over that thing. Fine. So now here are today's like topic for today is discussion of the pandas. So I will just import my pandas library. So for importing, what I would just write, import pandas as pd. fine. So this pd is the short form which I have given to my pandas library. Fine. So I will just quickly run that thing. So it has been successfully run. Fine. So firstly, I have imported my NumPy library, and secondly, I have imported my pandas library. Now here, firstly, I'm just going to tell you that basically how you will just read the data, read a CSV format data from the pandas library with the help of pandas library. So let's say I just wrote here df. Now df is the short form which I have just given to the variable in which I'm just going to read my CSV format data which I am having, right? So I just wrote df is equal to, now here I would just write pd. Now pd is a short form for my pandas library which I have given, right? So I just wrote here pd dot. Now I will just put a dot, I would just like write here as read underscore csv. So basically here I am telling that which kind of data I want to read. So the file data which I am having is CSV. Now basically what is the CSV format data? So CSV format data is a data in which the values are comma separated. So the full form for CSV is it the same only comma separated values. C for comma, S for separated, and V for values. Fine. So this is basically how we just read our data. For that we just need to take a variable, that is I just taken here as df. You can just take off your choice. Then I just wrote pd.read. Okay, so pd is my short form to my pandas library. I just put a dot, then read underscore csv. Read underscore csv is the basically format of my note, you can say just data which I am having. Fine. I would just put a bracket. Now inside that bracket, what I'm just gonna do, just let me do one thing. Yeah, so inside this bracket, what I'm going to do, okay, hold on, So here I'm just gonna write, okay, just let me do one thing. Let me zoom out for a little while because like it will like create a problem. Fine, I will just like here, just hold on for a second. I will just write df is equal to pd.csv. The name for my csv file is sample, right? So I will just write here sample.csv. Okay, so sample.csv is the name for my file which I have just taken right now, in which I'm just going to show you some example. Fine, so the name is sample.csv. So what here I have done, I will just again repeat that basically here I have just taken a variable and that is df. Now df is equal to pd.readcsv. readcsv is the file. It is basically telling me that, okay, I have to read my CSV file. CSV is a comma separated values file. And in the bracket, what I have given sample.csv. Now, what is the sample.csv? Sample.csv is the name for my file which I have taken. Now, what I would do, I would just run this. Now, let's see basically what is happening. So, it is saying me sample.csv is not done. Okay, so I would just like put the semicode. So, just 1 second. I would just put this one and this. And now, just run the program. Fine, so now it has run. So basically what I just forgot to put these semicodes. I need to put the semicodes, and inside that semicodes I just need to write the name for my file, whatever the name of my file I am having. Fine, so this is the basically idea. Now basically how to just read this whole file. If I just want to say that basically what are the rows and columns which are present in my file, so what I would do, I would simply write the name of my data frame, whatever like I have given. So here in my case I have given df, right? So I will just write here df and run. So basically what it will do, it will display me the whole like all the rows and columns which I am having in my data set. So this is a sample data set which I have just made on my own. I have not taken this from any site or something. So it was a sample one which I have just taken. So roll number, name, age, class and marks. So these are the things which I have just involved in this like sample.csv. fine. Okay, now what else I have? So this was about the like reading of the data. If I just want to read some rows, some particular rows of my data, so what does we use? So basically what I will use, I will just use df.head. Now head is one of the functions which is like used to display only and only some rows of my column. So let's say I have this written here as df.head. Fine, so what it will do, so inside this head, what is basically happening, it will automatically print me the top 5 rows of my data set. Let me just quickly run that thing. Now you can just see that it has automatically printed me the top 5 rows of my column, that are like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, roll number, age, name, name, age, class and marks. So basically what does this head do? This basically lets like prints me the top 5 rows of my call of my data set, what I'm having. So inside this head, if I just mention any like particular number, let's say I just mention this, so it will automatically like print me only three top rows from my data set, whatever it is I am having. So this head function is used for printing the top rows. Now if I just want to see the last some rows of my data, then what function we basically use? So that is df.tail. Now tail is one of the functions which is basically like taken here for writing the and displaying that last five rows of my column. I would just run that thing for a while. Now you can just see that I just got my last 10 rows from the downside, and that are basically roll number 10987656. So these are the five rows which are like present at the downside of my data. So this was about the df.head and df.tail. And inside this tail also, what we can do, we can just like enter any particular number. I can just enter, let's say 4. So it will like show me the 4 rows from the downside. So that are 9, 8, 7, and 6. These 4 row numbers it will show me, because these are the last 4 rows from my data set. So basically what does this head and tail function do? They basically help you to see the top 5 rows and the top down rows from your data set, whichever you are having. Fine. So here in this video, we have discussed basically how to read a CSV format data and how to use that head and tail function, how to view our data from the downside and even from the upside. So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and bye-bye.